For this video tutorial, we assume you have already an OSM user and you have installed JOSM in your computer.
As for the Tasking Manager, we assume you have already registered as user.
We will explain some basic JOSM settings, how to search for a UN Mappers project in the Tasking Manager, how to map one task, and how to upload the data to OSM. We'll start opening JOSM. To change almost any JOSM setting, we need to open the Preferences window. To do that, we go to Edit in the JOSM menu, and then we choose Preferences. Although it's easier if we use the shortcut F12.
In the Preferences window, we have a left panel with different tabs.
If we open the Display Settings tab, and we go to the Look and Feel tab, we can see the Language drop-down menu at the bottom, with which we can change the language of the JOSM environment to our preferred one. If we change it, for example, to French and we click on the OK button, we will be asked to restart JOSM. If we do, we will see that JOSM will be now in French. Let's now add our OSM user to the JOSM preferences, so every time we upload our map changes to OSM, JOSM will automatically use that user. To do that, we go to the Connection Settings tab, we select Use OAuth under the Authentication tab to assure a more secure connection with the server.
We click on the Authorize Now button. We fill the username and password fields. And we click on the Authorize Now button.
This creates a pair of access tokens that we can test clicking on the Test Access Token button.
In case of success, you will get a window similar to this one.
Otherwise, you'll get a window telling that the OAuth authorization has failed, probably because you have entered either a wrong username or a wrong password. We accept the message and then we click the Accept Access Token button to validate the user. In order to let the Tasking Manager to load the data into JOSM, we need to go to the Remote Control tab and enable the Remote Control. We will also tell JOSM to load the data in a new layer. To finish with this JOSM settings, we will enable the Expert mode.
Let's open now the Tasking Manager in one browser.
First, we will choose our environment language. In our case, we leave the default English.
Next, we log in the Tasking Manager.
We enter our OSM username and password, and we hit the Login button.
In the next window, we click the Grant Access button. And we are welcomed in the Tasking Manager.
Before searching for any mapping project, and if we didn't do this before, we will set the preferred editor and language, going to Settings under our user avatar. We will choose JOSM as preferred editor, and in our case English as language.
Now we can proceed with the project search and selection.
To check what UN Mappers projects we have available for contributing, we click on Explore Projects.
Then on More Filters.
And we search for UN Mappers in the Organization drop-down menu.
We click Apply. And we get a collection of mapping projects. Let's choose the Ansongo project.
On the left side of the project's page, we can read a short description of the project.
And if we click on the Read More link, we can read a more detailed description. Let's click on the Contribute button at the bottom right of the page. This will zoom in the map. And a text with instructions will show on the left panel. Please, read carefully the instructions before you start mapping. Once you have read and understood the instructions, you can proceed selecting one task to start mapping. All white tasks, squares, are ready for mapping.
Yellow tasks are also ready for mapping, because the mapping of another user has been invalidated. Light blue tasks are not available for mapping, and they are waiting for validation. Finally, green tasks are not available for mapping, and have been already validated. We make sure we have JOSM running, we click on one free white task of our choice. We click on the map selected task at the bottom right. And all OSM data within the task boundaries will be downloaded automatically into an OSM data layer in JOSM. We see that the data is downloaded into a layer called OSM data.
There is another layer that shows us the task boundaries, and that it is not meant to upload it.
Finally, we have an imagery layer, with digital globe satellite images that we will use for our remote mapping. We will take our time to add the different features we are expected to map according to the instructions. Like rivers. Streams. Roads, like this track here. And its fords on the waterway crossings, etc. For those objects that continue beyond the task boundaries, like this river here, we will map them a little bit beyond the boundary, so another user that chooses the task covering that neighboring area will be able to continue tracing the waterway from the point we left it. Once we finish with the mapping of the task, we can upload the data to OSM. If we get warnings and/or errors, we solve them. When all is all right, we upload the data, and we add a meaningful explanation of what we have done to the default comment that we get in the change set comment field. We can now hit the Upload Changes button to upload the new data to OSM. Now we can go back to the Tasking Manager site, and we can mark the task as finished, and leave a comment to the other users involved in this Tasking Manager project. We finally click on the Submit Task button and we are ready to start another task.